Hi folks, Bob Collins for Diver Supply. In this video, we're going to take a quick look at what I call the Rolls-Royce of regulators. And they're made by Apeks, and what we're looking at is the XTX50 and the new MTX-RC. So what we've got here is this is called the DST first stage. It is an environmentally sealed first stage, and it's quite a hunk of metal, but what a beautiful hunk of metal it is. Now, Apeks is known for their quality and their features, and this does not spare anything. So what we've got is we've got a turreted first stage, which gives you some movement, like you see right here. It allows the unit to be fixed in many different positions. This happens to be on a single tank, my little 71 high pressure. And you could also use this, and it's very popular for side mounts or doubles, that sort of thing. So a lot of the technical folks really enjoy this particular first stage. Now, not only does it have a turret, but it's got four low pressure ports on the turret, and it's got two high pressure ports on this first stage. Now, underneath here, this unit is environmentally sealed, so that's going to help keep out cold water. It's available in the yoke, like what you see here. It's also available in a DIN version. This particular complete unit comes with a 28-inch braided hose with a little swivel here and a swivel down here on the second stage. And what we're going to see on the second stage here is it's got a small heat exchanger where the hose comes in. Also has an adjustment knob on the side that adjusts your cracking or braking pressure. And that, what that really means is the effort it takes to breathe in and get the unit to open up and give you air. It also has a lever right here that moves forward or backwards, and that's our Venturi adjustment. And if you're not familiar with what a Venturi adjustment is, it means when the lever's forward and the air comes out of the barrel, it's actually directed toward the diaphragm in the front. Then the air turns and comes and down in through your mouth. Now, if the lever's pulled back, it actually moves a little deflector off of that opening out of the barrel, and the air comes directly into your mouth, down your throat. Where I see it come into play, if I'm out drift diving, then I usually keep my lever forward. And if I have to turn and maybe swim into the current, then I'll reach up and pull that lever back to give me more air on demand. Now, this unit is all composite construction, except for the metal bits and parts inside. There's also some treatment inside that provides antimicrobial type of issues. And if you're not really good at keeping your regulators nice and clean, then it helps. Down here on the front, you're going to see the purge button. Now, the purge button is actually in what looks like an X configuration. And what happens is you can either push in the middle here and get a full free flow, or you can push on the side and just get a little bit of extra air into your mouth and into the regulator. Now that's a quick look at the XTX50. And what we're gonna do is now we're gonna shift over and take a look at the MTX-RC. Now here we're looking at the new MTX line. The MTX is kind of the new big dog out of Apeks. It doesn't necessarily eclipse the XTX200, but what it does, it takes a lot of those features from the XTX line, like the XTX50 we just saw, and implements a lot more cold water type of diving features into this particular regulator. Now, this regulator was actually tested by the U.S. Navy's experimental dive unit in 33 degrees of water down to 192 feet. And this actually, when they did that, this thing virtually became a block of ice and still functioned beautifully. Now, this unit is available in the yoke, like what you see here. It's also available in a den version. One of the things you're going to notice about this first stage, and it is an overbalanced first stage, like the XTX50 and like the XTX200. And what I mean by overbalanced, it means when you start dropping down in depth, it will give you the air you need. But if there's an out of air situation and all of a sudden you've got two divers trying to breathe off of one first stage, it will actually give you more air than necessarily one diver normally utilizes. And of course, as you go deeper, it will adjust the intermediate pressure coming down the hoses. So that's what's meant by a overbalanced first stage. Now, when you look at it, you're going to see it's quite industrial looking. I really like it. It's got your two low pressure ports on this side and two low pressure ports on this side. And like the XTX50, this is actually a turret up here. And underneath this cap, there is a fifth low pressure port. And it's great if you want to utilize this for side mount or whatever. Again, a lot of technical divers will utilize this new MTX regulator. Now, there are two high pressure ports lower on the body of the first stage down here. And of course, underneath here, this is our cap that protects our environmental seal. Again, one of the things you're going to see on this first stage versus the XTX50 that we just looked at, whereas the XTX50 is chunky and solid, this is very trim. And the reason is we're trying to exchange heat to take heat out of the water because you've got high pressure moving into a lower pressure area, which causes cooling. And if we can use some of the temperature out of the water to help keep this warmer, then it's less affected to freeze up. And you're going to see heat exchanger vanes here, and you're also going to see heat exchanger vanes here. Much more pronounced than almost any other first stage that you see out there. The MTX-RC comes as a kit with the hose and second stage, and it comes with a nice braided hose, and there is actually an additional swivel right here. And as we come down the hose, you're going to see down here on the second stage where the hose comes into the unit. And by the way, both the XTX50 and the MTX are both reversible so that you can utilize them in a reversed situation like on side mount. Now, what we're going to see is we're going to see again a much larger heat exchanger fins here on the second stage. When we look, we're going to see a big rubber bumper around the edge, and we're going to see a nice big purge button here. And one of the things that both of these units come with is a really nice ComfoBite mouthpiece. And you're also going to notice that we've got nice wide vents so that the bubbles go around your face. You can push this button here and change this out to more narrow, smaller vents if you would like. Personally, I like the bigger vents. Now, one of the things we're going to notice on the MTX second stage is this cracking pressure knob right here is much bigger for somebody that may have gloves on. It's got a very rough surface to it for gripping. And we've got our nice Venturi lever, just like on the XTX50 that I talked about before. When you buy the MTX unit, you get a really nice bag that it comes in. I think it would actually be better used as like a messenger bag or a shoulder bag of some kind, because most of us are going to take our regulator sets and put them in our kit bag. But this could be utilized for that. Now, that's a quick look at the XTX50 and the new MTX-RC by Apeks. I think they're beautiful regulators. Matter of fact, I like them so much, I'm buying this MTX-RC. So if you have any questions, maybe you dive one of these regulators, leave a comment down below. Love to hear from you. And if you haven't subscribed, please hit that subscribe button. We're on our way to 5,000 subscribers and love for you to be one of them. I'd like to say sorry about that little bright spot that kept appearing, but I wanted to get some good light on the front of these units for you guys to see it. But again, thanks for watching. And as we always say here, dive safe out there. See you again soon.